So yeah, looks like it's time. Thanks for coming on one of the last session, but at least we know that who is coming is interested in the topic. So first few words about myself, because I'm not much into this part of the world, to put it in this way. I'm living in Berlin, Germany, but I'm originally from Romania, somewhere in East Europe. By education, I'm a computer science software engineer, so a programmer, mainly doing C programming for the last 20 years or so. From this period of my life, programming, most of it is related to open source real-time communication, and most of it is what's now Kamailio SIP server. So I'm one of the lead developers right now, and actually the oldest active from the initial team of the project. I'll have a slide with the history. The project, it's used quite a lot out there. We even have our own conference with about 150, 170, 170 people coming every year. We do it in Berlin, but I'm also participating to other events. Usually it's North America and Europe. Otherwise, I'm working for Asipto, small consultancy company, focusing only on Kamailio related services. This presentation, because I was not sure about the audience, is more from user point of view, but if someone is interested from like developer point of view and enhancing the application, I'm available even tomorrow around here, or we have good forums out there. So the plan for this presentation is trying to give you the least the direction on building your own telephony service, or you can call it real-time communication, because you can use it even for instant messaging or presence. You can even extend it for image sharing and so on, to make it a bit comparable with the what's out there and is popular. You can build, not with Kamailio only, but services like Skype, WhatsApp, FaceTime, you know, everything that's in the market right now and used quite popular by different regions of this country. But of course, using open source, everything from the client side to server side could be open source, and more important, would be open standards, because actually you can interconnect with PSTN, so the classic telephony, or with mobile networks using the same protocol. So it'd be a very efficient way of peering with, you know, everyone out there in the telephony world. So yeah, practically what we have in this real-time communication, I put it in three categories. First would be the interaction protocol, what's used between these, let's say, entities that are in the network for communicating. In our case, and I have just put it for reference, it's a SIP session initiation protocol. It's an open standard defined by the Internet Engineering Task Force. So it's an international body for standardization of everything about the internet, a lot about the protocols, but it goes also beyond that. It's something similar to HTTP, more or less, if you ever had a curiosity to look at the network, what's happening. So practically you have some messages going from the client to the server, and then the response in the HTTP case would be mainly HTML, which is the payload. In the SIP case would be the description of the session. I want to do a video call, I want to do an audio call, you know, all this kind of interaction that you can do with the other party. The same standard is actually adopted by the ITU and GSMA. So practically SIP is used now on 4G, and I think here in Singapore you don't have any more like 2G or so. So if you are having a 4G phone, whenever you make a call, practically it's using the same protocol behind. So actually, as a matter of fact, with Kamailio we have the extensions that you can build a core network for 4G networks. So the core infrastructure for 4G networks for routing such calls. They are called IMS extensions. I'm not going to talk about it, but probably you are, it's another partial open source implementation from Metaswitch, but you need other components from that company. Otherwise, this is the only option if you like to start like an MVNO and you don't want to buy from guys like Ericsson and so on, would be Kamailio. And as a matter of fact, in many countries in Africa, because they don't have so much budget, there are companies using and actually contributing back to Kamailio code on the IMS extension. So what I wanted to say here is not only about using open source for your needs, which I do also, but you can actually start a real telephony service. So something that you can actually make money out of it, and it's a proved market, the real-time communication, and it's growing. The second component that I'm going to approach here will be the server side. So we have the protocol, we define it, we're going to use a SIP standard. Everyone can implement either server or client side based on that protocol. And now on the server side, it's where I actually act most of the time, being the developer of Kamailio. There are a couple of alternatives, and I'm gonna also present them because Kamailio has a dedicated role in this network. First, a bit of history, because if you search on the web, you might find different names, which actually are the same project overall. The project started in a research institute in Berlin, Germany. That's why I have this kind of logo of the city. Quite old, so started in 2001. It was made open source in 2002. But then by 2005, because it was quite popular, and the institute made a spin-off company to take care of commercial aspects with the project, that company was bought by Tekelec, a US vendor at that time, which meanwhile was bought by Oracle. As we wanted to continue with the open source branch, a couple of the developers, we had to fork it, and we created what was for 3 years OpenACR project. I have it in the green branch there. The SIP Express router was open source. They couldn't close it because the code was at that moment in not GitHub, because it didn't exist. It was BerlinOS and then SourceForge for a while. However, this branch, OpenACR, became famous, and we ended up in getting in sort of a trouble with a trademark issue. A US company claimed that we suggest its open source version of their telephony system, which had the trademark ACR, and by using OpenACR, we suggest its open source version of their product. So we decided to rename, not fight in court. Most of the developers and community at that moment was in Europe. Anyhow, going in court in US, it's a lot of money, just to put it short. So by a developer from Austria, we got this proposal with Kamailio, which is a Hawaiian word, which actually is the verb for talking, conversation. So this is actually, if you want to translate from English to Hawaiian, let's speak SIP, is gonna be something like a Kamailio SIP. So it looks something related, domains were free, no trademarks, so we choose this name. And from that moment, we have the SIP. Meanwhile, we'll actually merge back with the original branch, the guys at Tekelec push some good code, mainly for scalability and the foundation of the application, and that word including. And over the time, we practically continue as Kamailio project. Now, a summary, because again, it's more than 15 years of development with rather big companies involved in contribution. I'm putting here what you get with this application, more or less from the foundation of real-time communication. So one would be all this IPv4, IPv6, you know, don't worry if you are still on IPv4, it's working. If you combine the two, it's working. If you want to be on IPv6, it's working as well. It has all the upper layer transport protocol support, UDP, TCP, TLS. The rather new one, SCTP, mainly used by the large carriers in the core network because the end devices don't support it, as well as extension for what's called now WebRTC. So this WebSocket that you can have real-time conversation between two browsers with the latest Firefox, Chrome, and including Apple Safari lately, as well as Microsoft Edge. Extensions, we have in the area of telephony, voice over IP, we can do or route calls that are gonna be with voice, video. We have this extension to integrate with mobile network, voice over LTE, IMS, as well as the classic telephony, SIP I, SIP T. We have a small footprint, and at some point it was used on the WiMAX, if someone remembers that technology, in WiMAX antennas for optimizing the call routing path on large grids of such antennas. So it's suitable also for small embedded devices. There are also packages for Raspberry Pi. You can just install it quickly if you want. You can even bridge between the modern specs of WebRTC to a classic SIP phone, combining with RTP Engine, which is a project developed within Kamailio community, but it's a standalone application mainly, you know, for scalability, as the media transmission could be a lot of traffic comparing with signaling. A lot of extensions, especially for you know, scalability and redundancy and high availability, least cost routing, load balancing, and so on. I'll have some more details. The community is quite healthy, and there is no big company behind it, like controlling. So the Institute still collaborates with us mainly for the event that we organize, the Kamailio World, but otherwise they are not involved in the management of the project. It's community based. But on the other hand, we have like 50 developers. So who would afford to pay 50 developers per year? So that's even a lot for a rather big company to have 50 developers in-house for one application. Of course, they don't work like daily base, but they maintain their code, they improve it when needed, which is very, very useful. Now to look a bit from outside at some topologies, practically, when you have a session, have two devices that are here, like phones, but could be apps on the mobile, there is not a problem. And what I wanted to highlight, you can also interconnect with other servers because it's everything like IP based, and the main routing, it's domain based or IP based, and there is no problem that I'm running my own Kamailio for a SIP server and you run yours to interconnect between us. You just need to publish in your DNS the host name and IP address, and Kamailio will do the routing without issue. Of course, for small deployments could be a single Kamailio instance. For large deployments, you can have a hierarchy of like layers with a load balancer, a main proxy, least cost routing engine, and presence servers. Another quite popular use case is like for interconnecting telephony providers, which is more like the second part. Sometimes you need to do transcoding, sometimes you interconnect directly. Just to give you like a figure about the performance, because we had the scalability from the first moment of building this application, you can get with a stateless load balancer around 10,000 call setups per second. So it's new calls per second that could be routed with the application. And some people may think it's not that big, but if you think in like 1 minute and a half, you already processed 1 million calls in a single. And those are active because actually being signaling only and not dealing with media at this level, we don't really care about how many active calls are. So having like 1 million active calls in 1 minute and a half is not something that you can buy cheap from the big vendors like Ericsson or Huawei. And again, this is all free. There is nothing that you can buy. With telephony, typically you have some features related to media processing, like audio conferencing or announcement or voice box, voicemail system. For that, you would need to use something else. There are open source variants like Asterix and FreeSwitch, the most popular. There are a few more others, and Kamailio integrates very well with. Because again, we are only signaling processing server. You can think of it as a SIP packet router. We know that a segment of a packet actually represents a VoIP call, and we deal with that in Kamailio. But again, if you want to look at the basics, it's dispatching SIP packets left and right on the network. Why I actually said it's a framework, it's because you don't get Kamailio started and now it's a telephony engine. Kamailio has scripting routing as a configuration file. So practically you'll have to build something which represents your routing logic. Could be a least code routing engine, could be a load balancer, could be a combination, but practically you have to stack a couple of components together and then you get the telephony system that you want. So this scripting language has two roles actually. We call it like passive role, which is only interpreted at startup, would be like what IP address to listen on, how much memory to use, how many worker to create and so on. And then we have the one which is active at the runtime, and it's about deciding the routing of the SIP packets. For building this logic, we have some choices now for this scripting language. Initially it was only something self-brewed, so a custom script language, which actually is not a bad decision, because when you build it from scratch, even if it's like a new programming language, even a scripting language, you can optimize it for your use case. So we optimize it for all this large volume of SIP traffic. But then you get in some limitation. At the beginning, it was not that obvious because it was mainly used for plain telephony, connecting two people, making calls. But now everyone wants to integrate with social media or do some extra analytics. And the application, Kamailio itself, it's written in C. Now, writing in C is not that easy these days. And there are many libraries that you could reuse, but they are in other scripting languages. So starting with like 1 year and a half ago, we added what we call inside Kamailio the embedded interface for scripting languages, KEMI, which allows you, instead of using our native scripting language, to use Python, Lua, JavaScript, and a small tiny scripting languages. I don't know how many knows it. Squirrel, I added being the developer of that because looks like suitable for embedded devices. The interpreter is very tiny and could be useful in such cases. Of course, we have also support for like REST API interaction. You can make a query. This is the caller, this is the callee, to some application server. You get back like a JSON saying send it to that IP address or do whatever with this call. So if you are more into the API, we have plenty of options to do queries, to parse JSON or XML output and so on. Just to give an slightly idea about our scripting language, I have the right side of the slide, so practically that passive, it's at the beginning. Then we have modularity, where we have to load different modules, just an example here. And the active part, the scripting language, is like the, again, basic segments of if condition, matching on the type of the packets, and handling request replies from SIP server. Again, somehow approach that, you'll have to put a couple of components together to build something. Usually you have authentication authorization because you don't want anyone to make calls to your platform, but then you can go in the direction of the load balancing, in the direction of a presence servers and so on. With that, you load different extensions in Kamailio. Just to have an idea, because maybe not many of you are familiar with the project and also not developers, what would be the component that you will have to add for a load balancer? So practically you'll have to define a group of destinations. You put them in, assigned to a couple of them different IDs. Could be a text file, which is suitable for small deployments, or could be with a database. And then practically you have some route blocks that you have to put in your configuration file. Would be selection of the destination, and in case of failure, because maybe you send to one and that box is down, we have what we call failure route. So practically these two pieces of scripting you will have to add in the routing logic. This is loading the module and setting some parameters, so not that relevant. It's easy to put it. Kamailio, it's on Debian, so people think that installing now a telephony system, it's like a 3, 4, 5 fridges if you visited a telecom data center in the past. Now it's available on Debian. You can run it on your Raspberry Pi. There are few commands. The Debian has quite up-to-date version of Kamailio. You just install it. You can choose MySQL or Postgres or a different database as we support more. You enable some feature like authentication, storage for the user location, add your users, and then start Kamailio, then configure the application and like soft phones or desktop phone and talk between. In terms of the web interface for management, there is Sirenis, also open source. It's like a control panel for Kamailio, adding subscriber, visualization of some statistics. Otherwise, Kamailio is only the application for routing the calls. However, there are a couple of companies which build more like complete telephony systems, and they are also free and open source. So it's why I give you here a couple of them. If you search on the internet, you might find others like Isabel PBX and even Plivo for API for telephony. But these are more or less like distribution oriented on starting a telephony service in like half an hour, because they give you user-sided portal so they can see the calls that they did, the records for accounting and so on. Some of them, like cProvider, it's oriented to the operators, like Kazoo, it's oriented to hosted PBX. So you have a slightly different target for it. In terms of usage, it's again used worldwide, even by big companies like Orange or like the second telecom in Germany, 1&1. So your reliability is not a question for this one. I'm ending more or less with the option that you have for the client devices and applications. Practically, if you like to have the feeling of the phone, you'll have to pay some money because it's hardware, but there are plenty of them. Some more expensive like Cisco, Polycom, but also cheaper Grand Stream, but still good quality. And of course you can have either desktop application or mobile application, some of them open source, which I listed first, but some are also free to use. So sometimes it's a choice of you which one you want to use. So Lean Phone, it's available on all platforms, including Windows Mobile, if that still exists, but Android, iOS, and all the desktop distribution. Jitsi, Java, so it's running pretty much on every desktop. And then a couple of options for Android, as it's more open than the iOS. Then is this new WebRTC specs that, again, you don't even need to install an application on your mobile phone. You just go to a website, you will get there like maybe just an input form, you want to call that number and you are gonna click and everything is set up. However, as WebRTC is not defining the signaling, you'll have to load some Java script libraries, and I gave you the option here with the JS, CIP.js, CIP.ml at the libraries. CTX phone, it's I think relying on CIP.js and making that interface there. So practically it's adding a GUI on top of JavaScript library. If you want to build your own native application, there are some good open source C libraries, so you write it in C, C++, your choice, and that's a good startup, because they do actually more than SIP. They do also media processing like PJSIP and VersSIP. So your choice of that. And with this one, I'm ending this. For more information, you'll find our website has quite good community around it. The mailing lists are active, good reference documentation. And if you have questions, I'm also available around here, even tomorrow. Now, probably I have time for maybe one question, or if someone has a question, otherwise I'll be around and you can ask me here. Okay then, thanks again for coming here, and see you.